everyone, welcome back for a little TLC. So today I'm going to be talking about Earl Simmons, also known as DMX. In case you did not know, he passed away on April the 9th, I believe it was, from what some are saying was a drug-induced heart attack. So DMX was a very well-known rap artist. He did struggle with addiction, but did you also know that he preached the gospel of Jesus Christ? He was known for bringing several people to Christ, although he was a rap artist and although he struggled with addiction. I really struggled with what in the world I was going to talk about regarding DMX, because there has been so much going on in the media surrounding his death and also surrounding his life in general. And I think especially in the Christian realm, I've seen two different things. I've seen people who are basically like, how dare he talk about the gospel when he's struggling with this addiction? And on the other hand, I've heard people applauding DMX for pushing through his struggles to still talk about the love of Jesus Christ. I have seen videos of DMX where he is praying. He is a prayer warrior and he is still talking about the love of God. And the more that I thought about it, the more that I learned about the overall life of DMX, I really began to ask the question, where was the church? And I guess this is the question that God wanted me to ask. So I'm going to pose that to you all. Where was the church? When I think about this question, it causes me to not really look at the latter years of Earl Simmons' life, but rather I started looking at his childhood years. And I don't know if y'all know this, but DMX had a very tumultuous childhood. And so I'm going to highlight just a couple of instances where I think the church could have intervened and maybe played a major role in this young man's life. DMX was the child of two teenage parents. So I began to wonder, where was the church? If they're anything like the church is today, they probably were giving this couple the side eye. There was no indication that they were married at the time that he was born. And so where was the church? Older adult parents need wisdom and guidance. And so I can only imagine that these teenagers would have needed some support, some wisdom, and some guidance as they raised their children. Not only that, DMX suffered extreme physical abuse from his mother and also from his mother's boyfriends. And so I began to ask, where was the church? Where was the church who could have provided support and love for this child who was going through abuse? DMX was in and out of group homes. He was in and out of juvenile detention centers. And so I began to wonder, was anybody from the church in any of those places ministering to him? Did anybody support and love him from the church while he was going from place to place? He was exposed to drugs at a very early age and even became addicted to drugs at the age of 14. Because he was in the streets. And so I began to ask, where was the church? Were there any other avenues that could have been made available to this child when he was in the streets? Where was the church? Finally, DMX spent several trips going in and out of rehab, going in and out of the prison system. And so I really began to wonder, where was the church? Did anybody from the church go into these places, these rehabilitation facilities? Did they go into any of these prisons? Was anybody there talking about the love of Jesus? Not condemning folks who were there, not condemning DMX, but where was the church to talk about a God who saves and a Jesus who loves them? Where was the church? Was anybody around to minister to DMX? I don't know what life was like in New York for Earl Simmons. I don't know if his family would have been receiving of the gospel, but I believe that it's the church's duty and obligation to at least try. Even if his family wasn't going to be receiving, the church should have been at every single place that he might have been, in the schools, in the streets, in these group homes, in the juvenile detention centers, in the prisons, the church should have been there, because aren't we called to go and reach out to all nations, not just the people who make us feel most comfortable, but we're supposed to go to everybody to teach them about the love of Jesus Christ. Where was the church then? And where is the church now? We as believers do a very, very great job of judging people from the outside looking in, of condemning people. But God really is calling us to be more intentional about discipling people, about intervening, about just showing people the love of Christ, not condemning them. The message should be that Jesus loves them and that Jesus desires to save them. And we should be going out into all of these places so that people can hear that particular message. DMX probably would have needed more than just an initial conversation. He probably needed relationship with the body of believers, because that's what we all need. We need relationship with God, and we need relationship with other believers to continue to support us as we work out our salvation. Yes, I know that God can use anybody. Yes, I do believe that everything that DMX went through made his testimony all the more powerful. But why is it that we have to have people go through all this trauma and go through all these trials and tribulations before we consider their testimony to be legitimate? Can't we have some type of both and spiritual prevention unit where we are pouring into people and supporting people, but also have an intervention and some aftercare for when, not if, but when people really do fall short? I think we need all these things in place so that we can have some type of wraparound service in the spirit where people aren't falling by the wayside, where people know that they are supported in every single area of their life from their infancy all the way up to when they are adults. Who can you mentor? Who is God placing on your heart to pour into? Is it some school? Is it a prison? Where can you encourage your church to really get connected with other people? There's an entire world out there. There's an entire world of people who might never step foot in the physical building of your church, but we need to go out and meet them. We need to go out and reach everybody. I encourage us to be more proactive, because I believe that God was proactive when he made a plan for our salvation even before the beginning of the earth. So DMX, I salute you. I salute you for your work for the kingdom. I salute you for pushing past your struggles and allowing God to use you by telling others about the love of Jesus Christ, no matter what challenges you face and no matter what you had to overcome. And I pray that all of us are encouraged to push past our struggles, to not be ashamed of them, but to allow God to use us to be an example of his grace and his mercy. I hope that all of us are encouraged to actually be the church and not get so caught up in just doing church or just going to church, because the world truly needs us. And we don't need to be looking down on anybody. We need to acknowledge that all have sinned and fall short of the glory and try to pour into other people and be supportive of them and for them, because we all need that from time to time. I'd really love to know what you all think about this. Do you think that the church is many times missing from people's lives, but then comes in on the back end to condemn people for falling into sin or not following Jesus like we are supposed to? Do we have an obligation to disciple other people? If so, what can that look like? Where can we go? Who is God laying on your heart to support and to mentor? What population are you most passionate about? I really look forward to seeing you all's comments. Make sure you like this video and share if you like the content. I will see you all next week for a little TLC. Bye-bye.
Let us pray. Father God, I am just learning how to pray. Bear with me. First, I thank you for the life of everyone that's here with me. Then I thank you for the love you give me. Why? I don't know. I don't deserve it. And it hurts inside. Many a nights I cried, called your name out loud, but didn't call you when I was doing good, too proud. And still you gave me love. I wasn't used to that. Because most of the people that gave me love ended up taking it back. It's something new to me, so I'm begging you for time to adjust. Let me make it there. I will be one you can trust. What I stand for, I put my life on. I do. I guess what I'm asking is, show me how to stand for you. And I will rap for you, sing for you, preach for you, reach for you, teach for you. I will love you like you love me, unconditionally. And I will always be prepared for whatever the mission will be. Give the nutrition to me, and I'll properly digest it. And when I give it back, I will show you word, well invested. And whenever I go, before I go, let me give thanks to you, Lord, for my birth, for every day that I've lived. You gave me a love most of my life I didn't know was there. In the name of Jesus, I give you my life because you care.